Hi guys, welcome back to my channel, or if you're new here, welcome to my channel. I'm so excited to be sitting down with you guys today and kind of chatting with you one-on-one and give you guys an update about our wedding. I know I haven't really posted too much on YouTube about our wedding. I posted our engagement. I can insert that here and also put it in the description box so you guys can see it. And then I also put our engagement photo shoot, like our get ready with me. And then I also did mention a little bit in the video where I open up about my struggles. And I kind of hinted to you guys in that video that I was a little stressed about something. And in today's video, I want to kind of elaborate a little bit more and share with you guys my thoughts and feelings about planning a wedding and ultimately why we decided to cancel our wedding this year. So that is the big news. We are not getting married this year. We are not having our wedding back at home, but ultimately through all of the stress and all of the struggles, we have made our decision of what we want to do, and we are happy with our decision, and we're happy that kind of everything happens for a reason and it ended up turning out to be what is for the best. If you guys want to learn more about what is going on with the wedding planning process and what we are choosing, just continue watching. Okay, so I want to bring you guys back to our engagement. If you are new here, we got engaged on July 25th of 2020 while we were stationed in Germany. We went to Paris for a little trip, and that's where Evan proposed. Soon after he proposed, I dove headfirst into planning. I am a person that is a planner. I have dreamt about the day of me getting engaged and having a wedding for a long time. I've helped friends plan their wedding. I'm a part of wedding planning groups. Weddings are just my thing. I just love, love, I love weddings. So I started planning my wedding right away. I was so very excited about it. Right away, we decided that we wanted to get married the following year. We didn't want to wait anymore. We had been long distance for so long, and we were just so excited to get married. So we planned to get married on July 9th, 2021, back at home. While also wedding planning, we went through a lot of different changes in our life. We moved from Germany back to the States, to Washington, D.C. We went home for a little bit. I caught COVID. I had new jobs. Evan had a new job. We were adjusting living together for the very first time and moving. That was my first time being away from my family. Honestly, there has been a lot of big life changes in our lives during the wedding planning process, which has made it more stressful than usual. Because it was stressful, there had been a lot of events that has happened. And I don't know if you guys like heard this phrase, but they say wedding planning brings out the worst in people. I see it firsthand. I am a part of wedding planning Facebook groups. I just see how it can bring out family drama, friend drama, drama between you as a couple. And I don't know what it is, but I've seen it firsthand. I know it has made me stressful. It has made relationships through our family and friends stressful. And yeah, I just felt like something wasn't right. I told myself in the beginning of this year that I was going to base my decisions on feeling. I'm a very indecisive person, and many times I base my decision to please others, to make other people happy, what I think other people want, what I think looks good, what I think other people will think something will look like, more like what my spouse wants or my significant other wants. And sometimes I never truly base my decision on like how I will feel. And there's also a part of me that like fears that I'm gonna pick the wrong decision and I'm gonna regret it. So between the wedding process from last year and now, I was going back and forth like, do I want this or do I want this? Like, what is my dream? Is this my dream or is that my dream? And ultimately it has made the wedding process more stressful than it needs to be. And there's also been other side drama along with that. And it just didn't feel right. I have told my friends, I told my family so many times, like, this doesn't feel right. I don't know what to do. Like, do we keep the wedding? Do we not keep the wedding? Do we move it to a later date? Do we move it somewhere else? there was just something deep inside that kept telling me this doesn't feel right. I know wedding planning is stressful. I know that it is. But the amount of stress that the wedding had caused me at that time just made me feel like something wasn't right. I knew for sure I still wanted to marry Evan. That wasn't it. I just didn't know if like what I was doing was the right choice. So yeah, after much thought and then me and Evan talking, we decided, let's just sit down, me and you, let's talk about it. Let's take a few days to think of what we truly want. So for me, if I took all the elements away of what my family wanted and what I thought everybody else wanted and what would be the right decision, and if I took all of those elements away and I thought, what do you want? What would be your dream wedding? And for me, my dream wedding had always been a destination wedding. If you know me and you've seen, I love to travel. I love the experience. I love, you know, experiencing the culture, experiencing the food, being in a new place. You know, just feeling that experience of when you're on vacation is just a total different feeling. That is when I feel the happiest. Like when I'm on vacation with family or friends or with Evan, like it just feels amazing. It just feels like you have no care in the world. You're sipping a drink. You're doing all these new fun activities. Like your adrenaline is just rushing, and that has always been my dream. And the reason why I didn't choose that in the first place was because my dream was also to have it back at home so that I could have everybody be there all at once. Sometimes you can't have both of your dreams, and I get that. And through a lot of advice from other people, a lot of people just said, stop thinking about other people and start thinking about what you two want. Like, your wedding is about the two of you, and someone said, and I love this quote, your wedding is about the two of you, everybody else is a bonus. So pick what the two of you want, and if people are there, people are there, and if people are not there, then they're not there. Like, obviously it's sad, but at the end of the day, a wedding is to celebrate both of your marriage. So you want to pick what you want to do. Ultimately, we talked about it back and forth. We did the pros, the cons, what do we want to do? And we decided, with everything going on, and also COVID, I forgot COVID, like COVID was gonna make things difficult too with like what we wanted. Even though we're having it back home, it still was gonna make it somewhat difficult and kind of take away certain aspects in our wedding that we wanted. Also, money was a factor in it too. When you get married and set your day out for like a year ahead, it seems like a long time, but in reality, in wedding planning life, it's not. Like, you need to be booking things already. You need to have money for those things. Things add up, and we were like, holy crap, like, it's coming up fast. Like, do we really have the money to do what we really want to do this year? Like, do we want to have it during COVID? Do we want to sacrifice our dreams? Many things. Like, do we want to still have a wedding when we are stressed and in a stressful point in our life, when we're having so much drama? Like, no, we didn't want that. Like, there were so many factors, and ultimately we chose, and even though we really, really wanted to get married this year, like, that was one of the things that made us sad, because we didn't want to wait another year for a marriage and like finally be married to each other. That was the only thing that was pushing us back, and also our family and like wanting to be with our family. So ultimately, to decide, hey, this is about us, let's do our dream, and everything else will fall into place. And we did. So we decided, like, I wasn't even gonna share the news in this video, but I'm kind of excited, and I'm back in that wedding planning stages where I feel so happy, I feel so excited, and I kind of just wanted to share it with you guys and just put it out in the world, put it out in the universe, put out the excitement in the universe that we decided on a destination wedding. Just thinking about destination wedding and thinking about having a vacation with our family and friends and being married, like, it fits our story. Like, guys, we met in Germany. Our first date was in Amsterdam. We got proposed to in Paris. Like, our whole life has been based on traveling and based on new places and new experience. Like, why wouldn't our wedding be the same? And I just don't know why we didn't choose that in the first place. I really don't. I don't think we were in the right mindset to make that decision. And now that everything has calmed down and we were less stressed and we were able to be more level-headed and kind of tune into each other and make it about us, we got to make that decision for us. And we are both so excited about it. Like, we haven't been this excited about wedding planning and our wedding in so long. So we knew that that was the right decision. Destination wedding. And then we knew, like, we need to give people enough notice. We also need more time to save up. So that's why we decided to cancel it this year and we moved it till next year. I'm not gonna share the date with you yet. Looking back, I think that stress and everything was worth it because it pointed us to the direction where we needed and what we truly wanted. Honestly, things have turned out for the better. We are just happy with our decision. Yes, we are not getting married this year. Yes, we have to cancel. And if you would have talked to me about this a couple months ago, you would have seen that I was sad. But today I'm happy, and that's all that matters going forward. I'm happy. Next video, I'm going to be sharing with you guys a wedding engagement Q&A, giving you guys a little bit more details and sharing some fun aspects at our wedding. And I'm so excited. I have many more wedding planning videos to share with you guys, like touring our venue, wedding dress shopping, my bridal proposal boxes, so many fun wedding stuff. And even if you guys want to know a little bit more about like wedding planning, like destination weddings and planning your destination wedding, like I'm going to be giving you guys all of that. I'm sharing all of it with you guys and I'm happy to take you guys along with me. Happy you guys are here supporting me. You guys are amazing. That is it for today's video. I hope you guys loved it. And if you want to see more wedding content and more of me, please subscribe to my channel. If you liked anything in this video, please click the like button. Please comment down below anything. I'd love to talk to you guys. Supporting me supports my channel. It supports me. It supports my whole vision and this community that I'm trying to create. So I really, really appreciate it if you guys subscribe to my channel. And I hope you guys have a great day and I will see you guys soon.